Do you love him?
No, but I wanted to sleep with him.
And you'll want to again?
What are we going to do?
I think you should see Barry whenever you want to.
I say we let her off the hook.
Oh, she'll squeal.
Oh, it's her last day. She won't say anything. Now, what good's this witness to us anyway?
She knows too much.
I'll forget everything the minute I get out of here. I won't come in 10 miles of the place.
Okay, we'll trust you. But remember this. You let us down, and the next time you end up here, you're as good as dead.
Frankly, I don't know why the government wastes its money. I never will understand what makes types like you want to degrade and destroy anything that's halfway decent in this world. I mean, it's pitiful, isn't it? Now clean up that mess and get on with your work.
Were you upset over Ben Fulbright? What were you thinking about when you were tying the noose to hang yourself?
Oh, I'm going to get the governor.
Daphne! You leave me alone or I'll kill you. I promise I'll kill you.
Daphne, come on. You're only making things worse.
I don't care.
It's all right, Daphne. We've finished asking all the questions now, anyway.
Well, then you can go away and leave me alone, can't you?
I'm afraid we can't until we're sure you won't hurt someone.
I will if you don't go!
Don't you see they have to ask the questions because they want to help you?
That's right.
In order to get the help, that's why they're asking the questions.
He told me I was lying.
No, I don't think you understood.
He did. You heard him, didn't you?
They're just testing you. They have to be sure, Daphne.
Daphne, let me give you something to calm down.
No, I don't want nothing. Just go away.
The doctor's going in a minute. Let him give you some medicine before he goes.
I don't want no medicine and I don't want no doctor. I just want you to leave me alone.
But I don't want to go to the pound. It's not fair. I want to be the others.
Oh, come on. This isn't a punishment. This is just to stop you hurting yourself, that's all.
But I'm all right now.
Well, this is your chance to prove it. What happened this morning has done your case a lot of harm. I mean, what do you think those doctors are going to write in their report?
They didn't believe me.
Well, you didn't pick a very good way to convince them that they were wrong.
Oh, I just shouldn't have started this court case business. If it's so important to everybody else, why don't they do it? Why doesn't one of them go to court? I'm not the only one with PMS, you know.
Well, listen, you've come this far. Surely you want to see it through.
Mrs. M, I'm the one that's copping it all and questions from the doctors and all my mates laughing at me about Mr. Fulbright.
Oh, come on. Can't be as bad as all that.
It is. I just wish they'd let me die like
now, come on. Take it easy.
Why can't people just leave me alone? There's nothing good about living. I don't want to do it anymore. Why can't they just let me die like I wanted to?
Come now, Mrs. Reynolds. What we witnessed this morning were hardly the actions of a well-adjusted individual. She's a textbook criminal personality. Low intelligence, acutely antisocial, with overtones of paranoia.
You don't think that might have something to do with the pressure you've been putting on her? Normally, she's very well-behaved. She's the editor of the prison newspaper. She's done excellent work in the garden.
Well, of course, she wants to convince the parole board she's a reformed character or the victim of some questionable medical condition. Now, I suggest that what we saw this morning is her true personality.
No, I know better than that. Believe me, the best thing we can do is to leave her in solitary for today to settle down and then let her go back with the others. Let her have her flowers and her friends.
No, too much of a risk. She represents a danger to herself and to others. So I'm recommending to the department that she be transferred to a psychiatric facility.
That's a bit drastic, isn't it? I mean, even if you were right and she were trying to put one over us about the PMS, that doesn't make her a mental case.
Perhaps not, but I want to do a full psychological profile and I can't do it here. Probably only take a day and we'll pick up and deliver.
Don't worry, Mrs. Reynolds, she'll have the best available supervision.
I know I said the restaurant was casual, but I don't think they'll stretch that far.
What restaurant?
dear, oh dear.
Reynolds, lunch, 12:30, that restaurant.
I'm sorry, it completely slipped my mind. Anyway, I'm not sure I want to go now.
Oh dear, there's that look again. What have I done now?
I presume you've heard what happened to Daphne.
No, I haven't. What?
She tried to hang herself.
Why the hell wasn't I told? Because I was in court working all morning. Well, how is she right?
Oh, more or less, no thanks to you.
What do you mean?
She tried to kill herself, Ben. I don't have to tell you why,
Well, it wasn't anything I did. She was perfectly fine when I saw her yesterday.
Mm-hmm. Sorted everything out, did you?
Yes.
Let me see. You told her she's not really in love with you, just infatuated with the handsome, successful lawyer.
Well, not quite as condescending as that.
And you'll always regard her as a good friend.
Yes.
And she smiled bravely and said she understood and you were dumb enough to believe her.
She meant it. You're making out as if I deliberately set out to hurt her. For God's sake, I turned down a judgeship for this case.
You turned down a judgeship for the case, not for Daphne.
Excuse me.
Where are you going?
To see if she's all right.
Found out about Daphne. It doesn't sound good.
I told her. I said the doctors would want to keep her in.
No, it's not that. They've got her in solitary. She went right off this morning, smashed up the exam room.
Oh, my gracious, the poor child.
How is she now?
Well, all right, I think. But it doesn't sound good. I think she even had a go at the doctors.
Do you think Mrs. Morris would tell us what happened?
So she'll let me talk to her.
Mrs. Morris, has Daphne's tray gone up yet?
Well, not as far as I know. The kitchen staff is still organising.
Is there a chance I could take it up? Have a quick word with her?
You know that's not really allowed.
I thought I could just calm her down a bit.
All right, I'll see what I can arrange in the kitchen. Keep it short.
Well, what the hell have you been up to?
Oh, no, I've been having a rotten time. Now they've locked me up in here.
Yeah, I know. I heard all about it. Been a bit naughty by the sound of it.
Couldn't help it. Them doctors are giving me a really hard time. I wouldn't have hurt them. I just wanted to get out of there.
Well, you managed that all right.
Yeah, now look at me. I'm stuck in here.
Not for long.
It doesn't matter anyway. Might as well be here as anywhere. At least no one can laugh at me.
Nobody's laughing at you, Daphne.
Oh, not much. Everybody laughs at me. Or else they push me around like them doctors. Just wish I was dead. I wish they'd never found me yesterday.
Well, that's enough of that. If I thought you were better off dead, I would have let you jump off the roof now, wouldn't I?
Well, you should have.
Come on, snap out of it. Think how good you've been doing. You're learning the piano, you're editor of the paper. Gosh, who's going to do that if you're not here? Besides, you've got a lot of friends who'd miss you.
Miss me?
Yeah.
That's a joke. All I'm good for is making a fool of myself, like that time with Mr. Fulbright.
Well, why wouldn't you? You were lonely, and he was nice to you. Gosh, if he's half the fella you reckon he is, any of us would have probably done the same thing.
Laura?
Yeah.
I'm really unhappy. I don't know what to do.
Just give it a chance. Take things a day at a time and don't be so hard on yourself. You've got a lot of friends here, you know, who'd miss you.
Hurry up, will you? I want to count the tickets.
You wait till I finish selling me tickets. Jeez, what's the matter with you? I sold mine ages ago.
Well, maybe I'm not as smart as you are.
Yeah, maybe. Well, hurry up anyway. I want to get organised.
She's all right. She just got it into her head that we were all laughing at her.
We'll have to show her that we're not. We'll all have to be extra sympathetic when she gets back.
I would have been anyway.
Better get on with giving our little delinquents their last talking to
me. Right.
Oi, you two, over here. Before you start anything, I've got something to say.
Nikki, don't.
They can't do anything to us now. This is our last day and we're going home in a minute.
A lot can happen before then.
I don't care. I'm going to tell you what I think. No, me and Cindy said we'd come to these sessions and we knew you'd give us a hard time. But you didn't have to treat us like stupid kids that don't know nothing. And you didn't have to like doing it.
What makes you think we liked it?
Oh, come off it. You loved every minute of it. Well, I'll tell you something. You needn't worry about seeing me here again. And you want to know why? Because I used to think I was a nothing. But now I know what real nothings are. Well, you can take this place and stick it. I'm worth more than any of you. So thanks, but no thanks, okay?
Should someone go after her?
Well, I suppose we should, but why? We've done what we set out to do.
Didn't you see what she was doing?
Yeah, giving the kind of cheek that can get her a smack in the mouth.
No, she wasn't. Well, not really. I know it doesn't sound like it, but she was saying thank you.
Is that right? Well, what do you know?
Mr. Fulbright, Mrs. Reynolds.
Thanks, Joyce. Hello, Ben.
Hi, I just heard about Daphne. How is she?
Very lucky to be alive. She didn't hurt herself, not physically anyway.
And emotionally?
Bad. And our so-called medical experts didn't help, I'm afraid. She's being sent to a psychiatric facility.
What? No, no way. I'm not having that for a minute.
I doubt if there's anything you can do.
If it's against her will, and I'm sure it is, I'll get a restraining order. I'll go to every court in the country if I have to.
Ben, I can appreciate how you feel, but I think we both know how uncooperative the department can be when it wants to. By the time you get an order to keep her here, they will have already sent her.
Then they'll just have to send her back, won't they?
It's not as bad as it seems. She'll probably only be there for a day, and if you think about it, it could be the best thing we could possibly do for her. She has to have a proper psychological evaluation. The way she is at the moment, it might just save her life.
I want to see her.
Sold all the tickets.
Oh, about bloody time. Look, we can have the draw tonight then, because I've already made up the duplicates. Where's your money?
Where's yours? You know, it's an extra.
How, Lou?
People like me, they give me
money. How come, Lou?
I made up an extra block of tickets.
Oh, you didn't?
Why not? It was no trouble and it worked.
How many extra?
Five, that's all.
Well, just as well you bloody well told me, or we'd had double numbers being drawn. Look, where's something to write with?
In the cupboard.
Jeez. Oh, sure you only made up five?
Yeah.
Where are they?
There.
You're just too bloody hungry, you know that. Don't do it again, because there's just too much risk involved.
Oh, listen to her. Miss High Roller, 1985. It's about time you started playing grown-up games, you know that? Something that brings in enough to be worth the trouble.
And what's your idea of the big time, Lou? Getting kids to bring in pills for you? You didn't even do that right.
Well, at least I'll give it a go. All you do is play safe and get nowhere.
Don't like it? Give the money back.
I didn't say that.
Yeah, well, cut the wings and count the dough.
Glad to see you're all right. Gave me a hell of a fright, you know. Well, things can't be really that bad, can they?
They're sending me to a mental place.
Only for a few tests. Nobody will hurt you.
Yeah. Some more doctors asking me questions and treat me like I'm nothing.
They won't. Besides, I'll be there to see you're okay.
Yeah?
Just try and keep me away. Well, come on, cheer up.
Why?
Well, we're still going ahead with your case. Think how good you feel if you get your release.
No, it's not going to be different out there. It's just more people laugh at me, that's all. I'm better off staying in here.
Stop feeling so sorry for yourself. It's all in the mind. You're the only one who thinks people laugh at you. You've got a lot going for you, Daphne, really. When you're out of here, you'll be able to do something worthwhile. Something that'll give you a bit of confidence. I've got a new address for your parents. I think I'll be able to get some useful information from that. You've got to promise me one thing. Daphne?
What?
That you won't try to hurt yourself again. And we're trying very hard for you, me, your friends in here. We've got to know that you're trying also, not just giving it all away. Now, how about it?
Yeah, okay.
Good girl. From now on, only good things are going to happen to you. And that's a promise from me.
I suppose I should congratulate you on making it to the end of the week. But I really think that depends on whether or not you've learnt anything by being in here. Have you?
Yeah, I learned a lot.
Yeah.
Was it what you expected?
No way, it's the worst place I've ever been in. Don't know how you can stay and work in here.
Well, if you really mean that, it wasn't a waste of time.
Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
Thank the women, not me.
You got to be joking.
Don't you think you should?
I'm just bloody grateful I'm getting out of here alive. Those despots you got in there'd kill you as soon as they look at you. If I was in charge, I'd lose the key and let them rot.
Yes, well, whatever you've experienced is nothing to what you'd go through if you ever came in as prisoners. Remember that, both of you.
Not likely to ever forget it.
All right, you can go now. Good luck.
Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
But we have to do something. We can't just let them take poor Daphne off to an institution. We don't know that's what they're going to do. It's just a rumour somebody heard.
Yeah, but wouldn't it be awful if it was true?
Ah, oh, good riddance. Never to be heard of again. They never are when they're sent to the loony bin. That's what happened to Mason and Parker.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they were never heard of again.
Dreadful places. They put people on drugs and give them electric shock treatment.
Maybe we could protest or something.
We could have a sit-in or a stop work strike.
Oh, let's just have a riot and be done with it.
Look, we're not going to do anything that's going to stuff up Daphne's case any more than it already is.
She mightn't even get into court if we let them take her away.
It's not that bad. Kelly's just stirring. You may as well say people disappear when they go into the infirmary.
Who says that, Dan?
You know what I think? I think if it's true, it's probably the best thing that could happen to her. At least I'll stop her from hurting herself.
Well, I'll be honest, Nora. I never thought I'd hear you being so heartless.
Oh, bloody Ray. Last you've seen the light. How long have I been telling you? She's as weak as water. She won't even stand up for her mate. And don't think it'd be any different if you lot were in trouble, too.
Yeah, well, there must be something we can do to help.
Look, if we start protesting and carrying on, we'll only make trouble for ourselves. And we won't be helping Daphne one bit.
See? What did I tell you? Weak as water and half as salty.
Shut up, Kelly.
Well, I don't want to agree with her, love, but I think that if Daphne needs
our
help, then
no,
we should...
I don't want an argument about it. Now, let's drop it, all right?
I think I managed to reassure her a little. There's no question she's a mess. I only wish there was more I could do.
Do you think it'll damage her case?
Well, if there was such a thing as justice, it wouldn't matter. Whether or not she's a chronic depressive makes no difference to the fact that she committed those crimes under the stress of PMS. Well, no doubt the prosecution will try to maintain that she's some sort of unstable personality, but I think I can handle that one.
Let's hope so. Mm. Did she say anything about going to hospital?
Yes, she seemed less unhappy when I said I'd go along with her.
Oh, good. I appreciate that. Hello. Come on in.
Oh, good. I'm glad you're here. Anne, is it okay if I go and see Lexie for a minute?
Yes, of course. She'll be in the rec room. Would you take her through, please?
Yes, certainly.
Did you see Daphne?
Yes.
Ben, what I said to you at the flat earlier, I think I was a little bit unreasonable.
I think you were.
Well, if I say I'm sorry, can we be friends again?
Well, I'll have to give that one a little bit of thought, won't I? We can talk about it over dinner. Providing your mother agrees to come along as referee.
Oh, it's a nice idea, but I'll be working back. Some reports to do. I've got a new prisoner coming in. But if you need a referee, I think the waiter might oblige.
I suppose we could always tip him. When will you be through with Lexie?
Oh, I don't know. Not long.
I want to say I'll meet you outside the gate in half an hour.
Make it 30 minutes.
Maybe you don't mind my saying, but how the hell are you supposed to keep up with your daughter?
No idea. I've stopped trying.
I remember once the neighbour of a friend of one of my cousins went into a mental home. There was nothing wrong with her. She just liked talking to the birds in the back garden. But my dear, the things they
did. Will you stop going on about it?
Anyone wants to, I'll take bets on if we ever see Graham again. Even money says we don't.
Bets have got to be more than $1,000, though. Kelly's only into big time stuff these days.
Shut your face.
10 minutes, all right?
Right.
Hello, dear.
Hello, dear.
Didn't know we had a class today.
You haven't. I just came to see Lexie.
Oh, must be important to come in specially.
It's a little bit of shop talk, that's all.
Hi,
Lexie. I had a phone.
Private conversation, if you don't mind.
Right? Well, it probably should be, yes.
Well, excuse us then.
Yes, don't want to hear anything we're not supposed to, do we?
As I was saying,
yeah.
I had a phone call from the guy who bought your windsheeter. Do you think you could do other things besides windsheeters?
Oh, I don't know. I wouldn't have to sew, would I?
No, no, nothing like that. I'd bring the garments in. You'd put designs on them.
Yeah, I suppose I could do that. Why?
As I was saying, this guy phoned. He's a fashion distributor. He wants you to do designs on a whole range of things. Shirts, skirts,
yeah.
Stuff, you name it.
Oh, I wouldn't mind doing that. Give me something to do, I suppose. But look, I'm not going to do it for nothing.
I wouldn't expect you to.
You tell him I want some free shirts, you know, so I've got something new to wear when I get out. How many do you reckon I should ask for?
Lexie, I don't think it's going to be a problem. He's already agreed to give you a $2,000 advance against the sales of the first run.
Dollars.
I thought you'd like that.
He's going to give me $2,000.
Cash. And that is just the start.
You wouldn't be putting me on, would you?
Lexie, cross my heart and hope to die.
Oh,
isn't it fantastic?
Yeah.
So I'll tell him you're interested?
Oh, yeah.
Great. I'll get back to you as soon as I've lined it up.
Yeah.
I'll see you then.
Yeah.
Dead drunk. 3 o'clock in the morning. Neighbourhood's like a church.
Oh. Excuse me, Barry. Do you mind waiting a minute?
I'll be in the office.
Something wrong?
No, I just thought I'd pick you up and perhaps we could have a meal and maybe see a movie.
Oh, well, I'd like to, Joan, but I can't. If you'd rung earlier, I could have told you.
Something better to do, I suppose.
We're having drinks with a client, the chairman of a big retail group that's thinking of coming over to us. Now, I've got to go along and help get him on side. You know that's part of my job.
It's just a thought.
I'll only be a couple of hours. It'll be too late for a movie, but perhaps we could still go out for a meal.
Yeah, that'd be nice. I'll be at home.
There, I think I'm organised. Now, what do I have to get on the way home? A dozen eggs, bread and coconut milk.
Coconut milk?
Mervyn uses it all the time in his recipes. Oh, and I must check the mail when I get home.
I have to ask, how does coconut milk remind you to check the mail?
Well, I've entered Mervyn in a cooking contest and I'm dying to see if he makes it to the finals.
I got it.
Oh, Mrs. Reynolds, I thought you'd gone long ago.
Nice thought. I've been doing a report on the delinquent programme. I'm tentatively calling it a success, at least for 3 out of 4, anyway.
Well, I'd be interested to know how the women got that result.
So do I. Though I think it's probably better if we don't know.
Well, I'd better go before the shop shuts.
Luck with the mail.
Oh, you too.
Oh, I'm not expecting any.
That's when something nice usually happens.
That's the other reason I'm still here. New remand prisoner coming in. Papers just arrived. She's on her way here now.
Late in the day, isn't it?
Special case. The police had to pick up some personal effects from her apartment.
Accident, she says.
Hmm.
But going by what's here, it could well be.
Presumably the police know something that isn't there, or they wouldn't have charged her.
Yeah, I suppose so. Well, you needn't bother to wait. I'll do the induction.
The department want me to stay and see her settled in. The victim wasn't exactly a non-entity. I think we can expect some more unwelcome attention from our media friends.
Yes, I suppose we can.
Look, we're not going to do nothing to you lot! Shut up! Right. Now, for the drawing of tonight's Super Fantastic Jackpot, who's going to draw it?
Me?
Oh, yes, all right, why not? Here, let's have it. Will we give it a good shake up? Shake. And then we'll shake it some more. Just
draw the bloody thing, will you?
If I'm going to do it, I'll bloody do it properly, all right? Now, here we are. The lucky number is number 11.
I thought lucky, I knew it.
Is it bad? You've got 11?
What do you mean? Of course you haven't. Look, here it is. It's mine.
Well, what do you think this is, a pork chop?
Let me see that. 211.
Oh, look, something's got to be wrong. I mean, one of you must be holding them upside down or something.
Oh, May, check the box and see what other numbers are in there.
Look, and listen, you're still waiting there from the last draw.
We'll see. Who sold you your number?
I bought it off Margie Maternity.
What do you want to go and do that for?
Because I wanted to. What's wrong with that?
That's what I'd like to know.
Yeah, well, there's two of some numbers in here and others are missing.
I think you two better explain.
Yeah, well, we can do a...
I said explain.
Look, it's the first time we've rigged it, Nora, honest.
What's this wee caper? I didn't know what she was doing. I thought it was a straight game.
You lying bitch!
That's enough. Look,
come on, the screws will be round for lock-up any minute.
Don't get me madder than I already am. You're in this together. It isn't the first time. And when the council's finished with you, you'll wish you'd never been thought of.
Big deal. Anyway, you're wasting your time looking. Haven't got any dough. She had it all.
Then you better start thinking about where you're going to get some. Anyone whose number got left out in any of your games is going to get their money back. And you're going to pay up on both winners today.
Well, we can't, can we? I keep telling you, we haven't got any dough.
You just don't get it, do you? I'm not asking you to do it. I'm telling you. I don't care how, as long as nobody gets hurt. But do it.
Shoplifters are the ones. Tried everything. Tag alarms, security cameras, nothing stops the bastards.
Yeah, it's a problem all around these days.
What are you so-called security experts going to do something about it?
I know. Have everything rigged to explode if it leaves the store without first being disarmed by the checkout.
I like it. Blow the bastards away.
Yeah, listen, I'm going to contact and get you a very good deal on second-hand anti-personnel mines.
Oh, God, wouldn't it make things so simple if we could? excuse me.
Well,
He seems happy enough.
Yes, I think I'll reserve my judgment till we see if we've got his account or not.
Hello. Oh, hello.
Who are they?
Oh, just acquaintances.
Listen, what do you say when we finish up here?
What?
About coming back to my place.
Oh, no, I can't tonight. I have to spend the evening with my flatmate.
Your flatmate? Put her off.
It's her birthday.
We'll send her a card. You can't say we didn't have a good time yesterday.
I had a good time. I just can't tonight, that's all.
I've got a very big, comfortable bed.
Larry, I can't.
What if I said it was my birthday?
No.
At this moment, chilling in my refrigerator is an excellent bottle of champagne.
I can see I'm going to have trouble with you.
No, that'd be a good start.
Evening. Anyone care to sign those? Oh, lucky you're not afraid of the dark. It is a bit late, isn't it?
I'm sorry, Miss...
Morris. Mrs. Morris.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris. It's my fault we're so late. We had to get some things from the apartment.
I see. Well, just stand on the white line, will you?
Line?
Yes, over there. You can leave your bag. A pleasant change?
Yes, it's been no trouble at all, really. Don't think you'll be having it for very long.
Your name is Eve Marie Wilder, is that correct?
Yes, that's right.
You've been charged with murder and remanded to Wentworth until such time as a hearing can be set. Now,
Miss Morris, I didn't do it. Everyone says I murdered him and I didn't. I couldn't.
Well, I'm afraid that's not up to me. Could you just answer yes or no?
I'm sorry. It's just that everything's so strange. Yes. The answer's yes.
Right. Now, if you'd just like to take off all your jewellery and leave it on the counter there, I'll be with you in a minute.
Sure you've got the right one?
Not in my opinion. If she's the murderer, I'm the chief commissioner.
Now, you'll be able to wear your own clothes as you're on remand. But I'm afraid you'll have to spend the first 24 hours in solitary confinement. That's normal procedure.
Yes.
Any questions you'd like to ask?
No. Must be used to people saying they didn't do what they're supposed to have done. But it was an accident. It was an awful accident. I'd have died rather than deliberately hurt Robin.
There doesn't seem to have been any mention of bail.
I don't know. Adrian was there while they were questioning me. That's my solicitor. Then he was called away. Nobody mentioned bail to me. The only thing I did ask was to see Robin one last time, and the police wouldn't let me.
Well, you can phone your solicitor in the morning. If he arranges bail, you could be out by tomorrow.
I'm surprised to be here at all. It all happened so quickly. But I guess everybody says that all the time, too.
Well, we'll see what happens tomorrow.
I don't want to be a nuisance, but do you think I could get something to eat? I haven't eaten since lunch, and I'm a bit shaky.
I'm afraid the kitchen's closed.
I could get some tea and biscuits from the staff room if you think that'll help.
Yes, please, if it's not a bother.
I'll get them.
Sorry I'm late. Mr. Main insisted we go back to his hotel and talk about the account. I couldn't get out of it.
Couldn't you?
We can make it tomorrow night.
Can we?
Honestly, I couldn't help it.
Don't lie to me.
I'm not.
You've been with that sleazy little bastard of a manager.
Joan, you'd better be careful what you're saying.
I'd better be careful. I have been sitting here waiting for hours for you, hoping that just once you might treat me as if I was worth something.
You're making a fool of yourself.
Ever since the day I met you.
Well, you said it.
You won't even make the effort to deny it, will you?
Why bother? For what it's worth, I haven't been with Barry, but you're not going to believe that, are you?
I'd have to be damn stupid.
He wanted me to go back to his place, but I didn't because I didn't want to hurt your feelings.
Oh, yeah, tell me another joke.
What if I did anyway? Do what I like, you said. Just don't tell me about it, you said.
I didn't say anything about becoming a whore. Terry! Terry! Terry, I'm sorry.
just that you said you'd be home. I was looking forward to going out, and you should have said if you didn't want to. Terry, I'm sorry.
Thank you. I know you don't have to bother with me like this. I really appreciate it. Makes it a bit easier to face, well, whatever's going to happen.
Well, perhaps things won't turn out so badly.
Oh, I'm sure they won't. I really believe in thinking positively. And I know that once the police really look into it, they'll find out it was an accident. No, it's not that. I just can't get used to Robin being dead.
I think you ought to try and rest now.
I'm sorry. You see, he could never marry me. He was already married. But we loved each other more than most people could ever imagine. Now I'll never see him again.
I think it best if you try not to think about it.
I have to. I know Mrs. Reynolds said that I might get bail, but if I don't, if I have to stay here, do you think that I could spend a few days in solitary?
Why?
Well, I just like to be on my own. I just need to spend some time on my own.
I can't promise anything. Mrs. Reynolds has gone home now, but I'll speak to her first thing in the morning.
Thank you.
Hey, hang on. You two go in front of the council today. Remembered where you've hid everyone's money yet?
No, and I'm not gonna.
Look, you've already got me to give all my money back. What more do you want?
Not me. It's what the council's going to want. Lunchtime.
You've got me money, miss. Please don't hurt me.
Oh, rack off, Lou.
What are you doing?
What's it look like? I'm packing.
Oh, wait a minute. Let's talk about it.
We talked about it last night, remember?
So now I'm sorry. I was upset.
I'm not putting up with a scene like that every time I'm a bit late home from work. It's the best thing for both of us if I move out.
Oh, no, no, it's not, Terry. Look, I know I'm unreasonable. I can't help it. It's all so new to me. Please try to be patient.
Me be patient? I wasn't the one doing all the yelling and screaming last night.
I promise it won't happen again.
No, it won't.
Oh, Terry, please don't go. Look, it'll be all right from now on. Honestly, it will.
No, I need some freedom. I have to be able to see my own friends when I want to.
Yes, yes, I understand that. I really do. And I won't make claims on you. But please don't go.
All right. One more chance. Just one more.
Yes. Things will be fine from now on.
We'll see.
Well, it was in all the papers, not just this one.
Well, I haven't had a chance to look yet.
Oh, but it seems very odd, though.
Well, what do you mean?
About Eve Wilder being charged with this Robin Sanderson murder.
Odd?
Well, all the papers are implying it was some sort of tragic accident.
Oh, that's what she's claiming.
Well, I can't find any mention of her in here, or a lot that I can see anyway.
That's not so surprising.
I mean, don't forget, Robin Sanderson owned all these papers.
Yes.
Well, perhaps they're trying to avoid any scandal. I'm sorry, I think I'm being very slow this morning.
Eve Wilder was his mistress.
Oh.
Well, she's claiming it was all a terrible mistake, but the police have other ideas.
Well, otherwise she wouldn't be in here, would she? Anyway, what's she like?
Well, she's very glamorous. Sensitive. Well, she's nice.
Nice?
Well, yes, I think so.
Meg, that man was married with children. If you ask me, I know I'm very old-fashioned, but
Joyce.
I think she probably broke up that marriage.
I think you should meet her before you start making judgments.
Oh, perhaps you're right. See you later.
Oh, good morning. Can I help you?
Good morning. My name is Foster. I'm Eve Wilder's solicitor. I'd like to see her.
Yes, of course. We do prefer it if you let us know when you're coming so that we can organize...
I'm sorry. I would have called normally, but I'm a bit pushed for time.
Well,
and,
I'm sure we can arrange something. The visiting suite is being used at the moment, and so is the interview room.
I'll see her anywhere, in a cell if you like, but it is urgent.
Well, she is in solitary. If you don't mind seeing her in a cell, then I'm sure...
Anywhere.
Very well. Just come over here. Sign in. I'll take you through.
Hey, Kelly.
What?
I want to talk to you.
Oh, do you?
You better come up with that money Nora wants, or she's going to take it out on me as much as you.
Yeah, I reckon they will.
Well, they're not gonna. I already owe you for trying to load it on me.
Oh, shove it. If we'd done it my way, we'd be out of the numbers by now and onto something bigger.
Your way? It was your brainless mucking around that stuffed it up in the first place. Look, I'd have been set once this draw was over. I mean, some guy wants to pay me thousands of dollars just for colouring in T-shirts. Now, I mean, God knows how much trouble just because you mucked it up. You haven't got an ounce of brain, your whole stupid bloody body. Oh, you are nothing but a brainless bloody loser, and that's all you're ever going to be. You're the loser. Oh, right! Bitch! Oh!
Give me roses, I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are Christmas too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing.